And we're live on the patio this morning to talk about being in some sand. Well, not at the beach. That would be good. In the sand on the course, the golf course. Nah, not so good. We're joined by golf pro Mike Woods from Haggin in Sacramento talking about being in the bunkers. Not exactly where you want to be a lot of times, but it happens to everyone. So you're going to give us some tips and a little bit on the equipment that you might use to get out of the bunker shots.
Yeah, absolutely. If you have the right equipment and you know a little bit about technique, the bunker can be your friend. You can actually get it next to the hole every time if you know what you're doing.
And I've been out at Haggin lately, and the bunkers are looking good, and they're tough to get out of.
Yeah, they are. But again, if you have the right technique, you can do it. Now, it starts with having a sand wedge. A lot of golfers don't have a sand wedge. You don't need a pitching wedge. You got to have a sand wedge. And the reason you need a sand wedge is it has this big fat part on the bottom here that we call bounce in golf. In fact, on the wedge, it'll have a number like this 14. That denotes the degree or the size of this part on the sole or the bottom of the club. Now, the reason this is so important is when you set up to your golf shot out of the bunker, you want this bottom part here to be the part that hits the sand.
So you want that ridge to hit the sand first to kind of trap the ball.
Not the leading edge. You want the bottom part. So the secret is a sand wedge, first of all. In your setup position, start with the face wide open.
Okay.
And that makes it so this big fat part, the bounce down here, will definitely hit the sand first. And when you do that, what'll happen is the sand wedge will glide through the sand, as opposed to if you use the leading edge with a pitching wedge, it'll dig down into the sand and stop. And the ball won't go anywhere.
So I never knew all of this, and I've been trying to play golf for years now.
Yeah, the technique is key out of the bunker. Now, a lot of times we get asked, how much sand should you take out?
Yeah.
And a dollar bill is a great visual for you to have.
I thought this was just for me out here.
It is for you, too. But a great visual to have is you want to take out a chunk of sand about as big as a dollar bill when you hit the shot.
Okay, so you want that little ridge part right here to start here.
Exactly.
And kind of drag all the way through underneath the ball.
Right, and another key part is as the sand wedge comes in, like you said, it starts back here an inch or two behind the ball, and it glides down underneath. And did you know that the sand wedge itself never hits the ball? It's the sand in between the wedge and the ball that throws the ball out onto the greens.
You know, that's probably why my bunker shots go way over, because I'm probably getting the ball instead of the sand.
So you want to just glide it right under, and then it'll glide back out. Yeah, and so start, again, key is start with the club face wide open. Take a nice full swing, and if you take a chunk of sand out about the size of that dollar bill, you'll get it up there on the green almost every time.
Wonderful. Golf pro Mike Woods from Haggin in Sacramento. Hope to get out there soon.